man. Well, the reason that I chose Elvis Presley to open up the show and everything was because Elvis was the beginning of all of it for me, and when it comes to music, you know, and I was born and raised outside of Memphis, and of course the influence of Elvis Presley was just enormous everywhere, but especially where I was. So, you know, I used to get up on the, when I was that age right there, that was me, I was up on the hearth and stuff, and that was my stage, and I'd sing and dance and act like Elvis. And this right here was Christmas time, and I got a cowboy set with a rifle and shit in there, some pistols and stuff. Good luck giving that to your kids these days, you know? They don't play on the playground, they get shot by the cops. Here's a song that I feel like kind of is what my mom's mentality was when I was around that age. Because I'm sure, you know, I'm a parent now. I got a 4-year-old and a 7-year-old, and it's easy to get flustered. You know what I'm saying? So, and I was a hellion when I was a kid, no doubt about that. So I drove my mom fucking crazy. But I don't think that she was on pills or anything, but this is kind of the mentality that she was in. Song called Mother's Little Helper. What a tragedy! Back when Bobby and I were touring together, man, Hank would come out every once in a while, whenever he could, whenever we were close by, and he would party down with us, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir!
And one thing about old Hank, though, man, he wrote a song that I absolutely love, and I always enjoyed it and everything, but now I can look back on it and I can reflect on it and think to myself, I really understand where he was coming from when he wrote this song, because, you know, things are a little different for me now. I'm not as crazy as I used to be. I don't do some of the things I used to do, needless to say. So here's a little bit, let's play a Hank Williams song, all right? And I'm sure it's much like it is around here, you know, we're all in the South, man. So it's like, I grew up in cotton fields and soybeans, and it's like on the weekends and stuff in high school and stuff like that, we would go out and we'd set up a big bonfire in a field, and we'd all circle around the bonfire in our pickup trucks and shit like that. Somebody would bring a keg of beer and we'd all tap into that thing, man. And the thing is that there was always country music that was playing, man. And for me growing up, you know, I was like, I wasn't a huge fan of country music, and all I ever wanted to listen to were the Beatles and Elvis and Van Halen and Led Zeppelin and the Cult. And then I got older there, and it was like the Sex Pistols and Suicidal Tendencies and stuff like that. You know, I always just fucking wanted to rock and everything, but I couldn't help but hear and absorb the country music that was around me and everything, because it was just always being played. So, and later in my life there, I learned to go back on it and listen to all those songs again and begin to understand what it was about them that was truly, that people really gravitated towards, you know? And it wasn't about just, you know, the simple chords and things like that of it. It was the storytelling that really captured me, you know? And I'm not talking about the shit fucking country music that's out right now, especially. You know, there's a lot of shitty fucking country music out right now. It's just stupid. You see the videos for some of these songs, and it's like, you fucking out of your mind. And it's like, wow. I'm talking about country music from artists that actually knew how to write a fucking song and they had something to say. I'm talking about Merle Haggard. I'm talking about Waylon Jennings. I'm talking about Hank Williams Jr. I'm talking about Conway Twitty. You know, these guys knew what the fuck was going on, and those guys are the ones that Nashville didn't want around. Nashville shunned them, you know, and you know. But at the same time, while Nashville was saying we don't want you, they were going, well, fuck you, we don't want you either, Nashville. So. And here's the man right here. This man right here, he was a master of that shit. He knew how to tell a story, and he knew how to make it impact your life. His name is Johnny Cash. Be the fly on the wall. you know, so to speak, and listen to Ray and Robbie tell some amazing stories about them going through their lives and through their careers and, you know, the ups and the downs of the chaos of what was the Doors, you know, and Jim Morrison and just the fun moments, the really bad moments, and then the confusing moments for me, you know.
So
there's a lot of all of that, you know. So Ray is gone now. He is up in heaven with Jim, and they have a band together again, you know. And I think Jimi Hendrix is playing drums or playing guitar. Excuse me. He might be playing drums. Who knows? He's a bad mouth follower.